In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet Volume of Pyramids and Cones. Our directions are to find the volume of each figure and to round our answer to the nearest tenth if necessary. Now, for the volume of a pyramid and a cone, the volume formula is going to be 1/3 of the area of the base times the height of the figure. So again, that volume is 1/3 of the area of the base times the height of the figure. Let's get started with number one. So in number one, we can see that the height is 7 miles. And we're given that the radius of the base, since the base is a circle, that radius r is equal to 2 miles. So we need to calculate the area of this circle because that's the area of the base, which is needed in our volume formula. The area of a circle is equal to pi r squared. So we'll just plug 2 miles in for r. So that'll be pi times 2 squared. 2 squared is 4, so that'll be 4 times pi. So now in our volume formula, we'll have 1/3 of 4 times pi, and then we're multiplying that by the height, which is 7 miles. Now we'll just enter this into our calculator. 4 times 7 will give us 28, and when we divide that by 3 and multiply all of that by pi, we'll get 29.32, which rounds to 29.3. And since our units are miles, for volume, our units are miles cubed. So in number one, our solution is 29.3 miles cubed. In number two, I'll write the volume formula again. For a pyramid or a cone, volume is going to be equal to 1/3 of the area of the base. I'll just write that area of the base as A times the height of the figure H. And remember, this area A is the area of the base. So number two, we can see that our height is represented by this red dashed line, and that's 4 miles. So now we just need to calculate the area. The area of the base, notice that this is a right triangle for the base, and the area of a right triangle is 1/2 the base of the triangle times the height of the triangle. But since this is a right triangle, it's simply the legs of the triangle. So 1/2 of one leg of 3 miles times the other leg of 4 miles is equal to the area of the base. So 1/2 times 3 times 4, 1/2 of 4 is 2, and 2 times 3 is 6. So the area of the base is 6 miles squared. So now let's enter that into our volume formula. Volume is equal to 1/3 of the area, which is 6 miles squared, times the height of 4 miles. 1/3 of 6 is going to be 2, and 2 times 4 is 8. So the volume in number two is 8 miles, and that's 8 miles cubed, since we're dealing with volume. And you can see that we have miles squared times miles will give us miles cubed. Moving on to number three, rewriting the volume formula, volume is equal to 1/3 of the area of the base times the height of the figure, h. Our height is represented again by this red dashed line, so that's 12 centimeters. And our base is a square. So area of the base is equal to length times width, which 11 centimeters times 11 centimeters will equal 121 centimeters squared. So let's plug that in for the volume. Volume is equal to 1/3 of 121 centimeters squared times our height of 12 centimeters. Typing all that into our calculator, 1/3 times 121 times 12 is going to give us 484 centimeters cubed. In number four, we have a rectangular pyramid. So volume is equal to 1/3 of the area of the base times the height. The height, again, is still represented by this red dashed line, and that's 5 inches. And since our base is a rectangle, again, area is a length times width. So that'll be 2 inches times 5 inches. 2 times 5 is equal to 10, so we have 10 inches squared for the area of the base. And now for volume, we'll just enter in area, which is 10 inches squared, and multiply that by the height, 5 inches, and then take 1/3 of that. So 1/3 times 10 times 5, 10 times 5 is 50, and when we divide that by 3 or multiply that by 1/3, we get 16.66, which rounds to 16.7 And this is volume, so we're in inches cubed. Volume equals 1/3 the area of the base times the height. The height is represented by 11 yards, the vertical dashed line. And you can see that we have a regular polygon for the base. This polygon is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sided. So the number of sides is 5, which makes it a pentagonal pyramid. So the pentagon is the base, and the side length of those sides is 12. And that's 12 yards. And it also gives us our apothem of 8.3 yards. So remembering our area formula for a regular polygon, area equals 1/2 of the apothem times the perimeter, which is n times s. So let's plug in what we know. We know that the apothem is 8.3 yards, and we know that this is a five-sided figure, so n is 5, and the side length is 12 yards. Typing that into our calculator, 1/2 times 8.3 times 5 times 12 will give us 249, and that's 249 yards squared. So now that we know area and height, we can solve for volume. We'll have 1/3 of the area of the base, so the area of that pentagon was 249 yards squared, and we're going to multiply that by the height of the pentagonal prism, which is h of 11 yards. 1/3 times 249 times 11 will equal 913, and that is yards cubed. So 913 yards cubed is the volume in number 5. And number 6, our base is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sided. So the number of sides is 6, which makes this a hexagonal pyramid. Also note that the side length, S, is 6 meters. And our apothem is 5.2. So volume equals 1/3 of the area of the base times the height. We'll solve for the area, which is equal to 1/2 of the apothem of 5.2 meters times the perimeter, which is n, of 6 sides times s of 6 meters. Entering that into our calculator, 1/2 of 5.2 times 6 times 6 is going to give us 93.6, and that's meters squared, since this is the area of the base. Now in our volume formula, we have area, 93.6 meters squared, and we just need to enter in height now. And our height is represented by this vertical red dashed line, which is 9 meters. So we'll plug in 9 meters. Multiplying 1/3 by 93.6 by 9, we'll get 280.8. And that's 280.8 meters cubed for the volume in number 6. And I'll go ahead and stop this video here. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. Continue on to the next video where I'll finish this worksheet completing numbers 7 through 14. And as always, like, subscribe, and share. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated.